In this lesson, I'm going to cover AWS Control Tower. It's important to understand AWS organizations before we move on to Control Tower, because organizations existed before Control Tower was released. And Control Tower essentially sits over the top of organizations and provides some additional governance, automation, and management features over the top. So let's have a look at how it works. With Control Tower, we actually are able to leverage organizations to create something called a landing zone. So the landing zone is specific to Control Tower. With organizations alone, you can create a very similar topology, but you have to do it all yourself, whereas Control Tower will deploy it for you. And this is what it looks like. It creates this set of accounts for you. And we have a security, a sandbox, the root management account, and a production OU with a production account in it. The landing zone is a well-architected multi-account baseline. So AWS have worked out what a good architecture looks like. This is the starting point for you. So it means you've got one production account, but obviously you can then add more. You can add your development accounts, you can add your test accounts by creating more OUs. But what they've done is they've started off this topology for you, including auditing, log archiving, a sandbox for dev test if you want to use that. And there's a whole bunch of preventive guardrails which disallow API actions using SCPs. These are put in place for you. So they're not leaving it to you to just make them up yourself. They're starting from a baseline and saying, this is a good architecture, it's got good security in it, it's your starting point, and from here you can customize and add to your needs. So the SCPs are attached at the different organizational unit levels. We then have something called detective guardrails. These are used for governance and compliance. And we have integration with Identity Center as well. So here we have the directory sources. They can be Identity Center, they can be a SAML 2.0 IDP, Identity Provider, or Microsoft Active Directory. So now we have the single sign-on capability integrating into Control Tower, which leverages organizations for creating this landing zone with a well-architected baseline for you of accounts, organizational units, preventive guardrails, and detective guardrails as well. Let's have a look at some of the shared accounts that come with Control Tower. First, you've got the management account. Same as with organizations, this is the account that's used to launch Control Tower, and it's the root of the organization as well. The root user and IAM administrator have full access to all resources in the landing zone. And in the management account, remember, as with organizations, because that's what we're talking about here, you cannot restrict actions using SCPs in the management account. We then have the log archive account. This contains a central S3 bucket for storing a copy of CloudTrail and AWS config log files for the other accounts in the landing zone. And then we have the audit account, which aggregates and stores logs collected from all other accounts in the landing zone. So here we can add that auditing information. We can centralize CloudTrail and config. We can make sure through the detective guardrails and the preventive guardrails that nobody is modifying these policies. For example, our auditing information is very important information. It might even be a requirement for compliance and security that you have a copy of this information from all accounts in your organization, and you don't want any individual administrator in an account to be able to stop that auditing process from happening. So the guardrails, we have the preventive guardrails. Purpose of these is to proactively prevent policy violations before they occur. So they enforce compliance and security best practices by restricting certain actions or configurations. Essentially, we're talking about SCPs, service control policies. You'll know these from AWS organizations. They limit the API actions that are available. So even if somebody has supplied a specific API action permission in an IAM policy, they still cannot perform that action in the account because it's completely sort of overruled by the SCP. It's not allowed by the SCP. There's a few preventive guardrails that are put in place for us. Some examples are disallowing the deletion of CloudTrail logs and S3 logging buckets. Of course, we don't want anyone messing with our auditing information. Disallowing public read access to S3 buckets, requiring encryption on EBS volumes, and disallowing RDP or SSH access from the all zeros IP, which means any source address. Next up, we have detective guardrails. These are designed to monitor and report on policy violations or non-compliant activities that have already occurred. So here we're talking about AWS config. So you'll know that config is about compliance. So we can set how our resources should be configured, and then we can ensure compliance with those policies. Using AWS config rules and then using Lambda functions for evaluation and even remediation as well. Examples here will be detecting publicly accessible S3 buckets, detecting whether versioning is enabled for S3 buckets, and detecting whether encryption is enabled for RDS instances. Also monitoring for IAM policies that grant overly broad permissions. So very useful. So we have the preventive guardrails restricting API actions using SCPs and the detective guardrails finding policy violations that occur, which mean that our resources are not in compliance with whatever our security policies are. Now let's just finish with a comparison of organizations versus control tower. Organizations, as you know, is about managing multiple accounts within an organization. You get consolidated billing, so you have a single credit card for the entire organization. And it provides us with organizational units where we can organize our accounts and then apply policies. And those policies, there's a few different types with organizations, but maybe the main one for restricting API actions is the service control policies. But we then have tag policies, backup policies as well. We then have Control Tower. This extends the capabilities of organizations. So when you're using Control Tower, you still have all of these capabilities of organizations, and you can still manage those capabilities of organizations independently. But Control Tower kind of sits over the top and provides that landing zone for you, that best practices deployment with a series of different accounts. You get federated access with IAM Identity Center, centralized logging, and the account factory for automation of deploying AWS accounts. You also have the guardrails. So that's a series of detective and preventive guardrails that are put in place for you according to AWS best practices.